is involved and engaged with his work. The cobbler, shoemaker, of course you see that the client is also very interested in what is carded. This is probably his most famous painting, also his most expensive one. It was sold through the Chatham Gallo Foundation for around 350,000 a couple of years ago. But the most interesting thing is that even in the paintings of Anger and Delacroix and others, here you see a painter, Discart, who has painted a painter. Painter there is painting this earthware, and all the other items, like here, the copper pot, the lantern, and other things that are also on other paintings. A man who is loading his rifle, also signed again in Tangiers. A guard, signed in Paris. Mm-hmm. You still can see that the lamps here have been painted. This is a watercolor, like Cornell, probably on the same. And here a naked lady on a leopard skin. Some people think that this car was naughty at this time, but I don't know. It's anyway, it's a very large painting. A girl. Again, musicians, also on a table that you can recognize also. And a leopard or another skin. And this is a man from the diplomatic service of the Emperor of Germany. It's the Count Castel Budenhausen, who was the German envoy at the time. It's not, it's here signed Tangiers Maroc, but we know from the correspondence with the Count, and we still have the invoice that it was painted in 1897. It's now in the Schloss Budenhausen in Würzburg. This was a rather alternative count at the time. He was a diplomat, but he wrote also about Morocco. And he, yeah, the strange thing is that in Bayern you have princes, and they were erhöht in the Fürstenstand as a Protestant family, whereby in majority is Catholic. And that was also to integrate that family in the environment of the German Emperor William II. Nevertheless, in the letters that remain of him, he is rather critical sometimes also, and was later also not enthusiastic about the entrantship of the German Emperor in Agadir, but that was much, much later. This is also the threshold of the other paintings. So this is an orientalist painting, but also a portrait. This one is recently discovered. It's an old painting of Discart from 1882, and it was made in Constantinople in Turkey. So it means that also he has been there. Then we go over to the Dutch portrait. Discart lived at Prinsengracht 103, a very fashionable quarter of the Hague at that time. He didn't live in the home house, but he hired two chambers. And this is the country house Wilbergen, where Leon told us about. And I go a little bit further. But these two paintings, very large one, of Karel Marien Baron Bransen. He was a member of the second chamber for the Anti-Revolutionary Party. And these portraits both are about 2 meters high and 1 meter.
It's not glass. It's not a glass.
Social security system and so on. But in the 19th century, that has not always been that way. And in fact, the country was ruled by around 300 to 400 to 500 families, and one of the families was the Bronson family. This was their third house, but they had around 11 houses of this type in the environment of Arnhem and The Hague. This was their newest one, and I discovered these two paintings. I've just shown, and there was nothing, absolutely nothing about the Dutch portraits at all. This was their second house, the Buiten Greve Poort in De Steeg. It's opposite where Louis Gutierrez, our author, a famous author, had also a small house, the ground he bought from the Bronson family. And this is a picture of the photo books of the family Bronson. Here you have Karl Marie Bronson, member of the second chamber. This is his wife, Mrs. Bronson van Limburg-Stieren. Here you have their daughter. They both, all three were painted by Discart. And here you have Discart himself.
Oh.
That's interesting, of course, because we know that the paintings were signed 1903, and that is exactly the date of this picture as well. This was the original home, Sittendaal, near Arnhem, now the seat of the foundation for Gelderland castles and estates. The older brother of Karel Marie Bronson, Gerard Bronson, you have him here, probably posthumously painted. It's probably also the oldest painting of this car of a Dutch nobleman. This is his daughter, Albina Bronson, painted 2 years later. It's in a private collection in The Hague. And this is her daughter, who was also painted by Discart, Maya van der Goals, as she was later called. Then here the Bronson paintings, here the family crest, the Order of the Dutch Lion, and typically the Dutch nobleman of that period. Here you have his wife, originally a countess from Limburg-Stieren. From the van Limburg-Stieren, he painted altogether six members. He kind of came across later on. And here you have the signature, J.B. Discart, 1903. This is their daughter, Amé Julia Bronson. She owned Radio Hof in De Steeg. And she was considered in Holland as the most beautiful lady of her time. She got a search from four rich, good-looking, noble people, but she didn't want to disappoint anyone, and that's why she remained unmarried. Whether it's completely true, I don't know, but it's certainly a beautiful picture. Here you see the Bronson family with Dolly van Holland, who was here. He was also painted, and what you can see is that the network of Dutch noble families was quite intensive, but so was the network of the painter Discart. I don't know whether the word network existed at that time, but absolutely he was in it. It was a good network. This is Amé Bronson as a young girl. In the book, if someone was painted by another painter before or after, it's included. This is a small drawing we discovered in a menu book, made probably at dinner or so for Polo Day. This is the castle Keukenhof, at the moment famous of the Royal Bulbflower Park in Lissen. It's now a foundation, but it was owned for a long time by the Van Linden family. Here you see Mrs. Van Linden from herself, Van Limburg-Stieren, and she was painted in 1902. Also her husband, Count van Linden, here dressed in as a servant of Queen Helena for the hunting area in South Holland. And then their son, who was painted here in oil in 1917 during the First World War. Holland didn't participate in that, and here in pastel. And what is particularly interesting in these paintings is that Discart painted the first painting in 1902, and then later in his life he painted the Earl and Countess in 1929. That means that he continued his contacts with this family for